There were some boats and barges astrand in the mud, and these enabled us to come within a few yards of her without being seen. I then signed to Mr. Peggotty to remain where he was, and emerged from their shade to speak to her. I did not approach her solitary figure without trembling, for this gloomy end to her determined walk, and the way in which she stood, almost within the cavernous shadow of the iron bridge, looking at the lights crookedly reflected in the strong tide, inspired a dread within me. I think she was talking to herself. I am sure, although absorbed in gazing at the water, that her shawl was off her shoulders, and that she was muffling her hands in it, in an unsettled and bewildered way, more like the action of a sleep-walker than a waking person. I know, and can never forget, that there was that in her wild manner which gave me no assurance but that she would sink before my eyes until I had her arm within my grasp. At the same moment I said, "Martha," she uttered a terrified scream and struggled with me with such strength that I doubt if I could have held her alone. But a stronger hand than mine was laid upon her, and when she raised her frightened eyes and saw who it was, she made but one more effort and dropped down between us. We carried her away from the water to where there were some dry stones, and there laid her down, crying and moaning. In a little while she sat among the stones, holding her wretched head with both her hands. "Oh, the river!" she cried passionately. "Oh, the river!" "Hush, hush," said I. "Calm yourself." But she still repeated the same words, continually exclaiming, "Oh, the river!" over and over again. "I know it's like me," she exclaimed. "I know that I belong to it. I know that it's the natural company of such as I am. It comes from the country places, where there was once no harm in it, and it creeps through the dismal streets, defiled and miserable, and it goes away, like my life, to a great sea that is always troubled, and I feel that I must go with it." I have never known what despair was, except in the tone of those words.